Bienvenidos a este nuevo vídeo de Beer TV. Estamos aquí en el stand de Beer en Essen, muy bien acompañados. We have Malik with us. Hello, Mike.
Hello.
How are you doing?
I'm doing really great. Thanks.
Well, here in the Fair of Essen, Saturday is always the most crowded day.
Yeah. Very crowded. Yes.
Well, but this year, I know that you are busy, but maybe not as much as the last year that you were with Pandemic Legacy 1, winner of Kennespiel.
Yeah, it's pretty busy right now with Pandemic Legacy Season 2 coming out.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great. Well, we have seen a lot of Pandemic Legacy Season 2 here in the firm. Yeah. People is really hyped. The game has been released a few days ago, I think.
Yeah, Thursday. It was worldwide, so yeah. It should be everywhere now.
And what are the first reactions of the people?
I've been happy. The early reviews seem to be good, so, you know, knock on wood.
Okay.
People are excited about it.
When we saw the boxes, there were the black and yellow. Why these colors?
Well, we had blue and red for season one. Black and yellow complete the four different disease colors for Pandemic.
Ah, great.
Yeah, if you can put them together, you get it makes a clock as well.
Yeah, also a clock. Then it means that there won't be more seasons of Pandemic Legacy?
Well, they let it slip that, yeah, we were working on a third season.
Yeah, on a third season, okay.
Yeah.
In how many years?
Oh, I don't know.
You don't know.
Yeah.
We haven't played season two now, but we have seen some things.
Yeah.
A map, strange map.
That's right.
What can you tell me about it?
Well, the game starts 71 years in the future, so 71 years after season one. And things have gone very bad for humanity.
But we did it well. What happened?
Yeah, well, yeah. You did it very well, and then things took a turn. Enough time passed.
Okay.
And so you start out, and a big plague has ravaged the earth, and what's left of humanity are floating havens, little safe spots in the oceans. And you're there, and your leaders have all gotten together for a conference, and then they never came back from the conference. And so you and your fellow players are just normal people, like teachers and sanitation workers and so on. And you step up to lead and find out what happened to your leaders and what happened to the world. So that's how the game begins. And it's a very small world. There's only 9 cities that you know of and your 3 little havens. Yeah, we took a lot of things and kind of inverted them. So in this game, you need to bring supplies out, and those are in cube form. So cubes are good, not bad.
Cubes are good.
Yeah, cubes are mostly good, and you're worried about running out of cubes. So there's a lot of things, and like when you begin the game, it's sort of like you've already lost, right? Because the world is in such bad shape, and you need to put it back together again. Uh-huh. So we had some fun. It feels like Pandemic, but some of the mechanisms are different, so it's fresh. It's a fresh take on it.
Well, you are talking to me, I'm thinking a bit about Seafall from the Biao, that you started with nothing, and then you start to explore, maybe.
Right.
Is a bit of this idea?
No, I mean, we did it because the story demanded it.
Okay.
But, Rob really likes exploring, and I do as well. We love the ability to explore. This game is different also in that you can decide we want to explore here or there. And a different group may do it in a different order. So it feels a little bit more, like there's more freedom.
Okay, and then when I took the box, it's really heavy.
It is. It costs a little bit more, but there's a lot more in the box. So, and we can't tell you what's in the box, but you hold it, it's heavy. There's a lot in there.
Yeah.
I can tell you that.
Well, enough surprises. That's funny.
It weighs a lot. So.
Great. Yeah. And, well, it's still a legacy game. We have seen some more legacy games nowadays. But what do you think about this mechanic today? Do you think it's going to be more games? Maybe it's going to be a bit more less? Or
I'm not sure. I mean, I honestly thought there would be more out because of the success of the first season. But they're difficult to design. At the same time, there's so many things you can do with stories and with permanence and things that I think people will continue to explore it. And you see little elements. The Creativity Hub is a game called Blank, where you write on a card every time you play. And it's just a little thing, but you make a permanent change. Yeah. And so you can kind of see the ideas filtering out.
Well, yeah, we will see.
Yeah.
And you can bring something from the season one to the season two as a player?
Oh, right. Rob and I talked about that a long time, and we decided no. They're detached. You can play two by itself. You don't have to play one. But the stories are linked. So if you play two first, then you can play one as like a prequel and kind of find out what happened. So it works either way.
Well, you told me, I think last year, that you were having an idea for a third chapter of Forbidden Island and Forbidden Desert.
Yeah, yeah. Stay tuned.
Stay tuned.
Stay tuned.
You can tell me nothing. Okay.
Yeah.
We'll keep it a secret.
Yeah, yeah. Well, don't tell anyone.
Well, Matt, thank you very much for your time.
Oh, thank you.
Have a great fair. And thank you for giving us those adventures of Pandemic Legacy, because we really enjoyed it.
You're welcome. Thanks for playing.
Thank you very much.